Yo, welcome back to another episode, Banks Garage, bruz. This time we're doing the car builders install. So I got stage one, stage two car builders. This is the sound deadening. This is a sound acoustic liner and like your carpet underlay. I've got some carpet up top there I ordered ages ago, so I thought I'd get this done a lot quicker, but that hasn't happened. Anyway, with the whole build, anyway, we're doing the painting at the moment, as you would have seen in the last episode. Mechanically, we're fine. Everything's running, cooling, sweet like that. Just the painting's taken a while. Anyone who's painted a car would understand that it takes very long, especially when you don't have solid time to do it. Like, I don't have days to just start sanding and sanding and sanding. Most of the time I'm doing this stuff is like now when the kids are asleep, or I do it at night and the kids are asleep and like the neighbors are obviously asleep, so I can't start, like, you know, the compressor up, and I can't start all that stuff up, so it's taking a little bit longer than I'd like. Anyway, other than that, I've done like inside these doors now, but we'll get onto that soon in the next video, right? But so the sound deadening today, let's get straight into it. I'm gonna take the seats and stuff out of the car. I don't have much room in the garage at the moment. As you can see, I've been emptying out my trailer and toolboxes. The other shed is getting moved. So we've got some sound deadening. So in here, I'm gonna start laying that, take all this out, move that wire, and start cleaning it with wax and grease remover. Because when I lifted this carpet, it was just like, I mean, who lifts a carpet on their car? Like, never. So it's 25, 27 years old, whatever it is. And the floor had never been lifted up. There's like 10 million sausage rolls under there. And just cigarettes and just crap, stuff like that. So you can start cleaning that now. We'll start laying the sound deadener. Shouldn't take too long. Being an older car and everything's easy to come out. We'll get straight into it now and let's do it. What? Yo. All right, just put the first piece down. I'm gonna need some practice with this, cutting around the holes and that. We got that first piece in, so. I don't know if you can hear that well on camera, but the tinniness is definitely dulled down quite a bit. It'll be really good, the whole car. I honestly can't remember what it was like in the car driving around. I know I've driven it recently, but I was sort of just listening to the engine and listening to anything, any nuts and bolts falling off as I drove down the road. So we're getting into this now, and now I've got the hang of it. I'll put the camera on, a bit of a time lapse, and you'll see me go. Yep,
nice work.
Well, the time lapse I set up didn't work, but I've started to go through the back now. We're starting to get in there, do a lot. So I'm sure that there's plenty of videos of this online, and like how to do this, but so you need to have some sort of roller, like they sell one, this one, or like you can just make your own, or if you got something else, just use that. But basically you just gotta lay it and then just follow the contours of everything with this. Like dead set, might even put a photo up in the corner. My son was just doing it and he's just over one and he was rolling it for me, so. Excuse the chair. That's the back sort of all happening now. So I might clear some crap out of here, then we can actually see the whole picture. But yeah, it's going down really quick. So I did the back in about half an hour. That's with cutting a few lines and just for the contours and stuff like that. It's sticky, it goes down, but it's really easy to pull back up. I've had to pull back up twice. Here's the little fella. He's in here, he's got the socket set. Yeah, really easy to pull back up. But I haven't done the back wall right now because like one of those boxes is good for like half the section of the car and then now the other half. So if I have any left over, I will do that wall. If not, I might just buy some later because there's no carpet on there, so I'll be able to just fold the seat forward and do it. Also thinking of doing the doors. Oh yeah, there's the paint. Didn't even paint the full inside. It's just too much sanding for me, eh? All right, cool. We'll get into it now, we'll keep going. And we're back. So it's the next day. I've pretty much done it. I just got to remove the gear stick to put it there, but I just sort of ran out of time. It's the May long weekend at the moment, so I was just doing family stuff and shit like that. So it's pretty much done. I'll take a video and show you that now. That's what I've still got to do along here, but that's got to come out. That's all sweet, that's easy. Still got to do with my offcuts along up the top, along each side, but I'm gonna leave a channel there to run the cables, but yeah. So with that, I had three pieces left with what you've seen left, so that should be enough to just do the cuts down the side. Won't be really much for the back wall at all. So two boxes does this car sort of perfectly, I think. Up the firewall enough and stuff like that. Quick review on it, I guess, the best sort of thing to do for stuff like this, because I was a bit unsure. Install, 10 out of 10, it's like easy as. Like I said, I did like the back half in like half an hour, front half took another like 45 minutes because I was like screwing around. Hey. Other than that, the sound deadening seems pretty good. I'll put a video there now of me tapping the transom, trans tunnel, and then next to it. Dylan, you give it a go. Yep. So you can sort of tell there what it's like. You know, it's sound deadening. It's not gonna, you know, it's not gonna be like silent inside. It just gets rid of that tinny, like ting ting sound. Just gives it more of like a thuddy sort of sound. So it will deaden it quite a bit. You know, your car's not gonna be silent inside, but it'll probably help with like sound systems and stuff like that. So I reckon installs 10 out of 10. It was easy. I didn't even have to. All I needed was scissors and that roller. Sound deadening itself. I mean, I haven't installed any others, but I was pretty surprised at how good it is. So let's give that an 8 out of 10. 10 being perfect. I don't know. 10's probably like you can't hear anything, but I don't know how practical that is. And yeah, like my son was easy able to do it. So I definitely recommend the car builder stuff. This is stage one. We're going to do stage two in the next video. Also, along with the upcoming, we've got to put this new dash in. And just, you know, start getting this painting. We want to start getting it out to Lakeside in the next month or so. So it's now like the 2nd of May. So hopefully by June, we're hitting the tracks and get some good videos of this on the road for you guys. So that's the car builder's install. Nice and quick and easy. Yeah, totally recommend it. It's pretty cheap too. I've got stage one for like $220 Aussie. And then the QC liner was like 160. So I'll chuck that in the next episode. Should be up next weekend. To try and get more videos going all the time now. So like, subscribe, comment below. I've actually started an Instagram now for this build, which makes it a lot easier for you guys to sort of message me, because it sort of gets missed a bit on YouTube, and I don't use YouTube for commenting on videos really, so I use Instagram. So put a photo of that here for you at the end, and yeah, get on and like that, and yeah, enjoy your week, and we'll come back to you next week. Say bye. Cheers, see you later.